So now, as you know, fscanf is used to read patterns from a file. Now we have a similar function, it's called fprintf, and we use this whenever we want to put some pattern inside the file. Okay? It takes the same parameter as fscanf, it returns the same thing, and fprintf is equivalent to printf if we put stdout over here. Alright? So, I'm opening a data.txt file in write mode. So let's say fprintf, I want to write inside my file that f is pointing to, let's write a string for example, and let's say hello. Alright? Build and run the program. Now let's go see our file. Open it, and you can see hello. Let's say I want to put also an integer, which is equal to 1 for example. Alright? Now build and run. Close this. Let's go see the file, and let's see. We have the string, space, and the number. So this space over here is important. It is put in here, right? So let me close the file, change this for example. Build and run, close this, let's see the file. And here you go. These spaces are printed inside the file. So the format of this string is important. And of course, if you put something in here, it will also be printed. Build and run, close this, let's see the file. As you can see, this hello was put inside the file. Perfect. So fprintf is just like fscanf, but it writes something in the file. And both fprintf and fscanf will return EOF if we have some error. Now over here, let me take this code and printf %d, and I will print fprintf. Alright, build and run, and have a look. We have 15 over here. So let me go to the file and count these characters. 5, 6, 7, 12, 13, 14, 15, right? And as you can see, here we have 15. So fprintf prints the number of characters written to the file. So to make this clearer, let's say characters. Alright? And now let me show you an example about this. Let's say I want to print something on stdout. And this thing is this over here. So build and run, and you can see this here. Alright? Put a backslash on, and this is our output. And this number over here is the number of characters, and it's 16 because at last now we have a backslash n. Alright, this is it regarding fprintf. Use it whenever you want to print something inside the file that has some pattern. Alright, later on we will have examples and you will master everything. So this is it, and I'll see you in the next video.